When we first started this company, people almost kind of took this as just kind of almost crazy science fiction. So, and I think we're getting past the believability factor. We're starting to see what was originally kind of research technology take flight in the clinical domain. And I think we're going to see many, many more of these type of technologies.
Here in St. Louis, a company called Neurolutions recently got one of the first FDA approvals ever for a BCI. In this case, a non-invasive EEG headset that reads the electrical activity of the brain. The measurements aren't as precise as with an invasive system like the one BrainGate uses, but they work for Neurolutions' purpose, helping stroke victims to reconnect their mind with a paralyzed limb.
All right, so we're just gonna test the headset real quick. All connections good, nice and relaxed.
My name's Mark Forrest. I live in St. Louis all my life, and turns out I had a stroke. And I was pretty much paralyzed on my right side. A lot of people told me after 6 months that I was pretty much done and I was gonna have hardly any movement.
When somebody has a stroke, a part of their brain dies. For instance, the right side is injured, the left side can't move. Now, but if you talk to these patients, they can imagine moving, they can try to move, they just can't actually execute that movement.
We know that 90% of those motor fibers that control opening and closing that hand are on that side where the injury occurred. What we found is that there's actually 10% on the healthy side, on the other side of the brain, that controls thought of, I want to move my hand.
And so what we did is we created a brain-computer interface that really has three parts to it. A wearable headset, a robotic exoskeleton, and a tablet that walks them through how to use the system.
All right, let's see. So let's do 30 seconds rest, and then I'm going to hit next, and we'll see what control you'll get.
At the beginning of the program, it tells you not to move your hand, but think about moving your hand, and that's what you have to do.
And then just imagine.
It's picking up that intention to move on the uninjured side of the brain. It's converting that intention to a movement of the exoskeleton. As the person continues to use it over time, it's essentially leading to a rewiring of the brain. There's this kind of neuroscience notion of what fires together, wires together. So when they're generating those brain signals to move and they're getting that feedback from that wearable, that's leading to new connections forming in the brain that allows eventually that uninjured side of the brain to take over control of the paralyzed limb.
My movement was just this. That's all I could do. Look how much difference I've made. Progressed using that machine.
I have arm movement, I have finger movement, I have wrist movement. It got me motivated to where I actually built my own fishing boat. My oldest son said it's gonna sink, it's not gonna float. My best friend told me it was gonna sink and not gonna float. Well, I proved them all wrong. Laura works in mysterious ways. Shit happens and nothing new about it. So you just make it work.